جاهزين يا شباب؟ هنعمل تجمع على فين؟
هنا يا صغيرة؟ اه بالظبط.
And the last, this is the team which is responsible for the needs. And we have two direct emails for requesting and receiving. Anas is responsible for the receiving items, and he is receiving through the email what kind of trucks and the manifest, so we'll be ready to send the trucks which is needed.
Answer all the questions, so it's all written up.
Yeah. Everything is written here and from whom to whom, and this is the problem that we have sometimes. We have a rejected item to go to some place. So in this time, when we go, we have to go. And we need to handle few layers of ballots, but there's the inside that is so. So this is why we consume our budget by sending the...
So this is why we are increasing our capacity of tonnage.
Covered all the details, but I would like to know what's the job description for these people.
We have here three teams. This team, this is the first team. They are responsible for accompanying the trucks, and they have another team. They are located in two places, in Nitsana and in Karam Shalom. So they are responsible for doing a direct communication. We have a problem as a leakage of communication here, especially for the blocking for what's happening through the Israeli side. And the government provide us with a walkie-talkie. So now we could be able to have a direct call with our team till the last point for the trucks. We send the main team sending the dispatching or doing the dividing of the type of the trucks to two pipelines. The first one, the team they are responsible for Karam Shalom. They are accompanying the trucks until they do the inspection and they do the offloading. As soon as they get finished their job back, they accompany this convoy back. The same is happening with Nitsana, but now we have a closure in Nitsana. And the last medical evacuation was done through Nitsana, and it was a very limited number with a lot of obstacles.
Thank the governor, you know, for the warm welcome to El Arish, to North Sinai. I mean, it's a real pleasure and honor to be a meeting with him and his team. I have to commend, you know, the folks at Egyptian Red Crescent. They've done an extraordinary job in assisting the people of Gaza and sending aid to Gaza. I mean, Canada is committed to peace in the region. Canada is committed to a two-state solution. Canada is hoping that will be a ceasefire, and we hope that it's done as quickly as possible. But again, you know, in cooperation with the governor of North Sinai, Canada is committed, you know, to make this a successful operation.
I'd like to about the Canada government situation towards this in Gaza Strip. There is no food, there is no water, civilian people killed, everything.
Yep, it's very much a concern to Canada. And up to now, we've given the people of Gaza $250 million. Aid is coming in from Canada to assist the people of Gaza. And we're privileged today in having a delegation from Immigration, Refugee, and Citizenship Canada looking at the possibility of accepting to Canada a further 5,000 people to give them, to take them away from the war zone, give them respite, you know, for a temporary respite in Canada. And we look forward to being able to do that. And again, you know, the governor of North Sinai has been critical in our endeavor and in assisting us in doing that. And as soon as we can get the people out, we'd be more than happy to welcome them home to Canada.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let me highlight the message side and on the practical side. And this is witness the practical side. I have His Excellency, the Ambassador of Canada and his team, and they witnessed the Egyptian efforts. And I would like to thank everyone who's working very hard. Hope to solve this problem very soon. Thank you very much.
بالعربي بقى معلش اللغه العربيه
طبعا انا بشكر معالي السفير كندا والطاقم بتاعه مصر بتبذل جهود قويه جدا جدا لحل هذه المشكله للقيام بدورها في الشرق الاوسط سواء على المستوى السياسي او المستوى الاقتصادي او المستوى العملي الجزء اللي احنا موجودين فيه هنا حاليا شاهد عليه السفير الكندي وطاقم العمل مدى الجهد الذي يبذل بفكر علمي عالي جدا بمعدات حديثة جدا ومكلف جدا وتم بصورة طيبة جدا احنا جاهزين لتقديم المساعدات في اي وقت هناك من يتهم مصر بانها تعرقل وصول المساعدات حضرتك ممكن بعد ما نخلص تسأل السفير الكندي انت رأيك ايه هل مصر فعلا بتعرقل المساعدات ولا لا انا بتوجه بكل الشكر والتقدير لمعالي السفير وطاقم العمل بتاعه كل العاملين المتطوعين وخاصة الفتيات اللي هم بتوع العريش والشيخ زويد ورفح على هذا المجهود المشرف لأبناء مصر شكرا جزيلا
شكرا
أول سكة في حياتي